Ever dreamt of being productive by just laying around and snacking all day? Let me introduce you to bison, a symbol of effortless efficiency. Bison are an important part of many different grassland biomes. Their presence makes the landscape ideal for so many different animals and species. How? For one, their grazing patterns help create habitats for insects, birds, and small mammals.
I got you, fam!
Another way they help? They wallow. They wallow, or they roll around on the ground and create shallow depressions in the earth. These depressions can fill with rainwater and become a rich habitat for aquatic species. Prior to European settlement, bison roamed much of the heartland and much of the continent, including here in Missouri. By the late 1800s, their numbers had plummeted due to government-sanctioned mass slaughter. The aim? To disrupt the way of life of the indigenous people who relied on bison for things like food and clothing. By the 20th century, fewer than 1,000 bison remain, sparking efforts to restore their population. Today, their numbers continue to increase. But despite the rise in their population, the ecosystems that they support are still in peril. Today, less than 1% of Missouri's original Tallgrass Prairie remains. For some perspective, Tallgrass Prairie used to cover at least 15 million acres of Missouri land. That's a third of the entire state. So what can bison teach us about grassland biomes, like prairies, and what they need to survive? Most of the bison that exist today are either located on private ranches or in conservation herds. The Nature Conservancy manages a herd of bison up at Dunn Ranch Prairie, which is a prairie conservation site located in northern Missouri.
We have just under 200 bison here. The initial reason for bringing the bison in was to help accommodate the prairie chickens.
Prairie chickens are a grassland species struggling with population decline in the face of a shrinking habitat.
Prairie chickens require a very specific ecosystem that the bison just naturally provide.
They do this by eating, literally. The bison's grazing keeps the grasses down, leaving open spaces that are perfect for the tiny prairie chickens.
I got you, homie!
They don't get into the water systems. They stay out of those for the most part because they have the wallows to drink out of.
That's right, those wallows we talked about earlier, they're multi-purpose. Kind of like a bottle of 3-in-1 shampoo. Bison wallow for several reasons, like when they get itchy, because they get bug bites, just like us. When they wallow, they also release seeds that they've collected in their fur from other parts of the prairie. They're like giant fluffy pollinators.
Aww.
So we know bison are really important for grasslands. But what makes grasslands so important? Well, the native plants growing at Dunn Ranch Prairie can tell us why.
The native grasses and forbs, they are very deep-rooted. And by being deep-rooted, they make the soil and water health tremendously better. They store carbon in the root systems. The grasses have tremendous benefits for cattle. We have several plants on the prairie that are either medicinal or edible. For instance, Harry Mountain Mint, you can make a tea with it. There's wild quinine, which is used for treatment of malaria. The Nature Conservancy in this area is doing all they can to restore a piece of the Tallgrass Prairie for generations to get to enjoy.
Prairies and grasslands in general are home for so many different creatures. Each of these creatures plays an essential role in maintaining these ecosystems, just like the bison.
It's not hard to realize just exactly how special the animal is. And whenever they say it's a keystone species, that's just kind of the key in the door to exactly how impactful this animal can be in an ecosystem.